In this video, we're going to look at one of the most iconic endings ever. The somber finale to The Graduate. How did director Mike Nichols turn two people sitting in a bus into a cultural touchstone?
I've come to talk with you again.
Oh, Jesus, God, no. Oh, Jesus, God.
By calling the shots. The role of the director is to take words in a script and turn them into cinematic language.
Hello, Benjamin.
Oh, hello.
But what does that process actually look like? We're going to use StudioBinder's pre-production software to put us in Mike Nichols' director's chair. We'll import the script, do our own breakdown, and build a shot list. With this exercise, we attempt to reverse engineer the iconic ending to see how and why it works. At the end of this video, we'll show you how you can get access to this project in StudioBinder to see it for yourself. Let's begin our analysis with the screenplay. To see how these tricky themes and story beats were handled, we imported the script by Buck Henry into StudioBinder. The Graduate centers its thematic exploration around heady ideas and emotions, like disillusionment, aimlessness.
Hi, Ben. What are you doing with yourself these days?
Oh, not too much.
And the generational divide.
I just want to say one word to you. Just one word.
Yes, sir.
Are you listening?
Yes, I am.
Plastics.
Exactly, how do you mean?
There's a great future in plastics. Think about it. Will you think about it?
Yes, I will.
Enough said. That's a deal.
And nowhere are these ideas more resonant than in the closing moments of the film. The story follows Benjamin Braddock, a college graduate unsure of what to do with his life.
Oh, Ben! Hey, there's the award-winning scholar!
We're all so proud of you.
Proud, 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 proud.
He needs something to fill the emptiness he feels inside.
How are you, Benjamin?
Fine, thank you, Mrs. Robinson.
And begins an affair with his former teacher, Mrs. Robinson.
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me. Oh, gosh.
Benjamin, I want you to know that I'm available to you. And if you won't sleep with me this time...
Oh, my Christ.
If you won't sleep with me this time, I want you to know that you can call me up anytime you want and we'll make some kind of an arrangement.
Then he falls for her daughter, Elaine.
Elaine certainly is an attractive girl, isn't she?
I've had this feeling ever since I've graduated. This kind of compulsion that I have to be rude all the time. You know what I mean?
Yes, I do.
Can we do something tomorrow?
All right.
But after they've broken up...
Elaine, I have to tell you something.
What is it?
That woman...
What?
That woman, that older woman that I told you about.
You mean that
yes,
one?
Yes, the married woman. That wasn't just some woman.
What are you telling me? Benjamin, will you just tell me what this is all about? Oh, no.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme.
And Elaine is about to marry someone else.
Glad to meet you, Ben.
Great meeting you, Carl. Swell seeing you.
Sorry we won't be able to invite you to the wedding, Benjamin, but the arrangements have been so rushed.
What the hell have you done?
I don't think you'll have time for that drink after all.
Benjamin decides to finally take action with his life.
Hey, fellas. Do any of you fellas know where Carl Smith is?
He took off in the middle of the night to get married.
Hey, where's the makeup king getting married? Say hello to Barbara!
Now that we have this climactic story beat isolated, let's see how director Mike Nichols stuck the landing. To emphasize Ben's struggle as he races to the church, let's use a telephoto lens to compress the perceived distance in the image. This will make it look like Ben is getting nowhere, even though he's sprinting at full speed, pushing his panic and desperation even further. The windowed balcony of the church, where the script describes Ben like a trapped moth.
Where's that guy? What's he doing? Take care of him.
He's too late.
Instead of showing the confused reactions of the guests, let's hang on to a close-up of Elaine as she drifts towards Ben as if in a trance. The only voice she wants to hear is Ben's. The chaos that ensues can be ideally captured with handheld shots. The escape from the church and onto the bus should be as thrilling as possible.
Hey, it's too late!
Not for me!
Then, the golden cross that he wields as a weapon and uses to bar the glass doors. Nichols maximizes the impact of the penultimate shot through the expert use of one simple ingredient, contrast. A sharp contrast in motion, energy, and mood. Let's cut to a POV of the passengers, which could just be any extras we can find. Or there might be an opportunity here. If we fill the bus with extras from their parents' generation, we can also tie this moment back to one of the core themes of the film, the generational divide. Their blank expressions will further highlight this juxtaposition of energy. A two-shot will maintain the shared experience of the two characters, whereas individual close-ups would isolate them. And then, the music.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
The Simon and Garfunkel track will add a great deal to the emotional punch of this moment. We heard the song before in a melancholy sequence of Ben lost and searching.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
And stand to the right.
Because a vision softly.
Playing the song again here lets us know that Ben is still just as lost. We'll let the shot linger so we can watch the excitement and adrenaline drain from their bodies as the truth sets in.
Still remains within the sound.
That this subversive act won't fill the emptiness they have inside. You'll find a link in the description to our breakdown of The Graduate in Studio Binder, where you can download the script and storyboards. Hit subscribe and ring the bell for notifications before it's too late.